Now I want to show you a process of factoring called grouping. And it's arguable that you already know how to do all this because you already know how to factor out the greatest common factor. Well, maybe we should review that. Okay, remember factoring out the greatest common factor? First thing we did was find the greatest common factor, looking at all three terms, 6, 16, and 22. The biggest number that goes into all three is 2. And x to the fourth, x to the third, and x to the second, the biggest expression that will divide into all three of those is x to the second. But recall, when the first term is negative, it's going to behoove us, and you're going to find out why this time in this video. We're not going to take out 2x squared, but we're going to take out negative 2x squared. Okay, how do we do that? Well, let's write it outside of parentheses, and then all we have to do is figure out what goes inside of parentheses. And recall from previous knowledge that we find that out by dividing. Now, don't be lazy. Actually write and perform the division. Don't do it in your head, because if you don't write it down, you don't know. You have nothing to go back to check it. So let's divide each term by negative 2x squared. And the first term we get, a negative divided by a negative, 3x squared, positive 3x squared. Dividing the next term by negative 2x squared, we get negative 8x. And then finally, we do the same thing to all three, dividing by negative 2x squared, we get minus 11, and we've taken out the greatest common factor. And that's the idea. Now, consider greatest common factor could be a polynomial. A polynomial. That's what this example is about. You see, you have two terms, but they both contain the parentheses or polynomial y plus 4. So we can do the exact same thing. What did we do? We use that as the greatest common factor. Now, when you have a greatest common factor, you put it outside of parentheses, just like before. And then how do you decide what goes inside parentheses? Divide each term by that greatest common factor. Dividing this by y plus 4, we get, of course, 8x, because the y plus 4 is canceled. And dividing the second term by y plus 4, again, they cancel, and I get plus 3. And I'm hoping you can see that I can actually take out, as a greatest common factor, a polynomial, or a set of parentheses. High five. Got it? Now, I hope you're saying, this is just taking out the greatest common factor. And you're right. It looks a little different than it did before. So,
thank you, sir. I'll have another.
Let's do one more example of a very similar thing with a little bit of a twist. Okay, now what's going to be the greatest common factor here? What's in both terms? I see an x plus 2 in both terms. So what do? Again, I write x plus 2 outside of parentheses, and I decide what goes inside parentheses via division, or canceling in this case. Dividing the first term by x plus 2, what I'm left with is 7x. And here's with the twist. Dividing the second term by x plus 2, now that's a subtraction sign, but it can be treated as a negative sign. So when you cancel the x plus 2s, you could say that you're left with a negative 8 or a minus 8. And that's your answer. Now, let's talk about how this is relating to grouping. And I'll tell you right now, you're only going to do grouping when you have four terms. And every time you have four terms, you're going to do grouping. And basically, this grouping thing is just doing the greatest common factor twice. Let me show you. I'm going to divide these four terms into two groups. We'll call this the red group or first group, and this the second or blue group. Okay, now let's just do the red group. Don't even worry about the second group. Just do that, and we're going to take out the greatest common factor. Do you see what the greatest common factor would be in both of those only? Hopefully you see it would be just A. And if I divide each term by A, I get what's inside parentheses. Okay, now that's the first group, the first two, or the red group. Now, let's do the second group. What do you think the greatest common factor between 2b and 12 is? Well, hopefully you can figure that it's 2. And if I take 2 out, I'm going to get a nice surprise. 2b divided by 2 is b, and 12 divided by 2 is plus 6. Now, we've done well, but we're not done yet. Do you see that there's a b plus 6 in both of these? So, as I said, we're basically just going to do factoring out the greatest common factor twice. Let's do it again with the result. Taking out the b plus 6 from the red group, I get an A, and a B plus 6 from the blue group, I get a plus 2. And basically, as I see, I've done the greatest common factor twice, and it's not hard at all. You already knew how to do this, is what I would say. Now, this is not hard, but it is a little bit different. So, let's look at another example that has, again, a little bit of a twist to it. We're going to divide it into the first group, the first two terms. And we're going to take out, let's see, an x. Dividing by x, I get 3y. Dividing that by x, I get minus 4. Now, in the next group, you might think I'm going to take out a 3. But since the first term is negative, remember what we said about when the first term that we're factoring is negative, we don't want to take out a positive 3, but rather, in this group, let's take out a negative 3. And dividing by negative 3, negative divided by negative, I get plus 3y. And dividing 12 by negative 3, I get minus 4. And son of a good thing I divided by a negative, isn't it? Because that switched the signs of everything, and now I have a common term, a common polynomial term, if you would, and I can factor that out. Dividing the red group by 3y minus 4, I simply get x. And dividing the blue group by 3y minus 4, I get a negative 3 or a minus 3. And son of a gun,
genius. That's what it is. Sheer genius.
I've got it. Now I have one very last example for you, and this is as hard as it gets, so. Looks about the same, doesn't it? Let's see what happens. I have the red group, and what do you think the greatest common term for these, well, let's see, between 6 and 27, I think I have a 3, and I see an x in both, so let's work with 3x. Taking out a 3x from the first term, I get 2y. Taking out a 3x from the second term and actually doing the division, I get plus 9. Now, here's where it changes a little bit. Looking at this group, what would be the greatest common factor? Well, you say, well, there isn't one. When there isn't one, we use the number 1. So we're going to take out, you'd think, well, I'm going to take out a 1. But wait a minute. The first term is negative, so I'm not going to take out a positive 1. When the first term is negative, I want to take out a negative of that number. So I'm going to take out a negative 1. And watch what happens. Dividing this by negative 1, I get positive 2y. Ooh, this is cleaning up. Dividing this by negative 1, I get plus 9. And oh, we've got a nice match, and we can do it again. We can do the grouping technique again. Taking out the 2y plus 9 from the red group, we get 3x. And from the blue group, 2y plus 9, we get, remember what we took out, a minus 1. And son of a gun. It doesn't get any harder than that. So,
what's all this jabber-whopping when there's work to be done?
Go do your homework.